Not all of the halogens are appropriate to use in the free radical halogenation reaction. For example, the F2 molecule, which forms the fluorine radical F dot, it is too unsafe to use in this reaction. Because of the small size of the fluorine atom, the fluorine radical is too unstable. It is so unstable that it is violently, explosively reactive. And therefore, it makes it unsafe to use in this type of reaction. On the other end of the spectrum, the iodine molecule, I2, because it is so large, the iodine radical is too stable. It is so stable that it reacts so slowly. It's so slow to react that it's essentially like no reaction is even taking place. So both the iodine and the fluorine molecules as halogens, they generally are not used in the free radical halogenation process. Instead, we focus on using chlorine and bromine. They're both in the middle in terms of size and stability and safety. In these two reactions here, I'm showing an alkane reacting with the halogen molecule in the presence of light, which forms a halogen radical, and that halogen radical then reacts with the alkane to form an alkyl chloride or an alkyl bromide. So again, both of these are good options to use. There is a difference between the chlorine radical and the chlorine radical and the bromine radical in terms of their reactivity. The chlorine radical is very fast. It's safe to use, but it is very fast. And because it is very fast, it is not selective. Meaning that when the chlorine radical reacts with the alkane, it is going to react in every single possible position on the molecule, and it forms a lot of different products. So we'll say all possible products. Sometimes this is a good thing because sometimes the only way that we can get a particular alkyl halide is to use the chlorination process because we know that it's going to give us every single possible product. The bromine radical, which is just a little bit larger than the chlorine radical, it's not super fast, so it is slow enough to have selectivity. And therefore, with the bromination process, we see the formation of a product that is consistent with the stability of the intermediates, which means that we can predict the products of this reaction.